الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. ما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى. Today we're going to start a new class. So we're going to be dealing with this class every Tuesday. And Monday we have the lines of poetry in Aqidah and Manhaj by Al-Imam bin Abi Dawood Sijistani, commentary of our Sheikh Abdul Razzaq, Sheikh Abdul Razzaq Al-Badr حفظه الله تعالى. And on Tuesday, we're going to be dealing with this book of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyya. The title of the book is called Al-Wabi al-Sayyib min al-Kalim al-Tayyib, which is basically a book of adkar by Imam Sheikh al-Islam Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyya, rahimahullah ta'ala. And the Sheikh, before I start talking about the benefits that the Sheikh and the Imam, rahimahullah, mentioned here, he said there's more than 100 benefits of dhikr. And before I go into that, I would like to read to you what he said about what does the sins and heedlessness do to the heart. And he said, رحمه الله تعالى, قال أبو الدرداء رضي الله عنه لكل شيء جلاء وإن جلاء القلوب ذكر الله عز وجل. He said, Abu Darda رضي الله عنه said, everything has a polish, and the polish of the heart is the remembrance of Allah. وذكر البيهقي مرفوعا من حديث عبد الله بن عمر بن عمر رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه كان يقول لكل شيء سقالة وإن سقالة القلوب ذكر الله عز وجل. وما من شيء أجلى أنجى من عذاب الله عز وجل من ذكر الله عز وجل. قالوا ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله عز وجل. قال ولا ولو أن يضرب بسيفه حتى ينقطع. الإمام البيهقي رحمه الله تعالى collected in his collection of hadith that hadith that is raised to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم on the authority of Abdullah ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, everything has siqala. Siqala is jala, same thing, polish. And the polish of the heart is the remembrance of Allah. And there is nothing that would save you from the punishment of Allah azza wa jal, would save a servant of Allah from the punishment of Allah more than the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. So they said, the Sahaba said, even al-jihad fi sabilillah. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even if one of you would strike with his sword until the sword breaks. And the Shaykh, rahimahullah ta'ala, Shaykh al-Islam, al-Qayyim, he said, وَلَا رَيْبَ أَنَّ الْقَلْبِ يَصْدَأُ كَمَا يَصْدَأُ النُّحَاسِ وَالْفِضَّةُ وَغَيْرُهُمَا وَجَلَأُهُ بِالذِّكْرِ فإنه يجلوه حتى يدعه كالمرآة البيضاء فإذا ترك صدأ فإذا ذكر جلاه. He said, and there is no doubt that the heart get rusted and get rusty like copper and silver and the like of them, and its polish is the remembrance of Allah, because the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal polishes the heart, and he makes the heart like a white white mirror. And he said, and if it is abandoned, then it will get rusty, and when you remember Allah, then it will get polished. And then he said, الذكر جلاء للقلب وصدأ القلب بأمرين بالغفلة والذنب وجلاؤه بشيئين بالاستغفار والذكر. He said that the remembrance of Allah is a polish for the heart, and the rustiness of the heart is through two things, al-ghafla, heedlessness, wa-dhanb, sin. He said, and the polish of it comes through two ways. The first one is seeking forgiveness from Allah Azza wa Jal, and second is remembrance of Allah. He said, فَمَنْ كَانَتِ الْغَفْلَةُ أَغْلَبُ أَوْقَاتِهِ كان الصدع متراكبا على قلبه. He said, if someone's most of his time is he's heedless, He does not remember Allah Azza wa Jalla. He's always heedless most of his time. He said the rustiness would accumulate on his heart. وَصَدَأُهُ بِحَسَبِ غَفْلَتِهِ And its polish is according to his heedlessness. وَإِذَا صَدَأَ الْقَلْبُ لَمْ تَنْطَبِعْ فِيهِ صُوَرُ الْمَعْلُومَاتِ عَلَى مَا هِيَ عَلَيْهِ فَيَرَى الْبَاطِلَ فِي صُورَةِ الْحَقِّ وَالْحَقِّ فِي صُورَةِ الْبَاطِلِ He said, and when the heart is, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, heedless, he said he would see, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, what is falsehood or false, he would see it in the picture of the truth, and the truth in the picture of falsehood. لِأَنَّهُ لَمَّا تَرَاكَمَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّدَأَ أَضْلَمَ فَلَمْ تَظْهَرْ فِيهِ صُورَةُ الْحَقَائِقِ كَمَا هِيَ عَلَيْهِ He said, because of the reason that rustiness accumulated on his heart and piled up on his heart, so much so that his heart becomes black and dark, so much so that the truth, he said, the truth do not appear or do not settle in his heart. فَإِذَا تَرَكَمَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّدَأُ وَسْوَدَّ وَرَكَبَهُ الرَّانُ فَسَدَ تَصَوُّرُهُ وَإِدْرَاكُهُ فَلَا يَقْبَلُ حَقًّا وَيُنْكِرُ بَاطِلًا And if this rustiness of the heart piles up on his heart until it becomes hard, it becomes black and dark, then he said at that time, Ran will cover his heart. Ran will cover his heart. And Ran, Abdullah ibn Abbas mentioned, explained it. He said, الدنب بعد الدنب, the sin after sin. He said, if the Ran gets covers his heart, he said, his imagination and his tasawwur will be corrupt. He said, so much so that he would not accept the truth and he would not object to falsehood. He said, وَهَذَا أَعْظَمُ عُقُوبَةِ الْقَلْبِ He said, and this is the worst punishment of the heart. وَأَصْلُ ذَلِكَ مِنَ الْغَفْلَةِ وَاتِّبَاعِ الْهَوَى He said, and the source of that and the origin of that is heedlessness and following one's desire. فَإِنَّهُمَا يَطْمِسَانِ نُورَ الْقَلْبِ وَيَعْمِيَانِ بَصَرَهُ He said, because heedlessness and following the desire, he said, they extinguish the light of the heart and they make the sight of the heart blind. قال تعالى ولا تطع من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا واتبع هواه وكان أمره فرطا. And he mentioned the ayah from Surah Al-Kahf that Allah Azza wa Jal said, the meaning of which, ولا تطع, and do not obey, and do not obey من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا, the one that we made his heart heedless away from our remembrance, and he followed his desires until the end of this ayah, that you can look it up inshallah for a better translation of this ayah in Surah Al-Kahf. And then he said, فَإِذَا أَرَادَ الْعَبْدُ أَنْ يَقْتَدِيَ بِرَجُلٍ فَلْيَنْظُرْ هَلْ هُوَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الذِّكْرِ أَوْ مِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ He said, if the servant of Allah wanted to copy a man, then he said, let him check, find out first of all, is he from the people of dhikr? Is he from those that remember Allah Azza wa Jal? Or is he from those who are heedless? وَهَلِ الْحَاكِمُ عَلَيْهِ الْهَوَى أو الوحي He said, and the other thing does he go according to the revelation, the Quran and Sunnah, or is he following his desire? فإن كان الحاكم عليه هو الهوى وهو من أهل الغفلة كان أمره فرطا ومعنى الفرط قد فسر بالتضييع He said, if his matter was that he was following his desire, he said, then he is from the people of heedlessness and his affair will be in loss. أي أمره الذي يجب أن يلزمه ويقوم به وبه رشده وفلاحه ضائع. He said, the matter that he must be taking care of and establishing, which involves his guidance and success, والعياذ بالله will be a loss. وفسر بالإسراف. And another explanation of that, that his mara, he went, meaning he went overboard. أي قد أفرط. وفسر بالهلاك بالإهلاك. وفسر بالخلاف للحق. And another explanation of this is perishment. This person is going to, in the road of perishment, or also going against the truth. وكلها أقوال متقاربة. And all this statement are very close in meaning. والمقصود أن الله سبحانه وتعالى نهى عن طاعة من جمع هذه الصفات. He said the point here that Allah عز وجل has prohibited from following and obeying the one that gathered all this characteristic. فينبغي للرجل أن ينظر في شيخه وقدوته ومتبوعه فإن وجده كذلك فليبعد منه. He said, and it is incumbent upon a man to check his sheikh, to check him out. And the one that he copies, and the one that he follows, if he founds him having this characteristic, which is he's heedless and following his desire, then he should stay away from him. وَإِنْ وَجَدَهُ مِمَّنْ غَلَبَ عَلَيْهِ ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَاتِّبَاعُ السُّنَّةِ وَأَمْرُهُ غَيْرُ مَفْرُوطٌ عَلَيْهِ بَلْ وَحَازِمٌ فِي أَمْرِهِ فَلْيَسْتَمْسِكْ بِغَرَزِهِ وَلَا فَرْقَ بَيْنَ الْحَيِّ وَالْمَيِّتِ إِلَّا بِالذِّكْرِ. He said, but if he founds him that he is overwhelmed and he always in a constant he's always remembering Allah Azza wa Jal, and he is following the Sunnah of Prophet Sallam, and his mara is not in loss, in a state of loss, and he finds him very resolute in his affair, he said, then he should stick to him. He said, وَلَا فَرْقَ بَيْنَ الْحَيِّ وَالْمَيِّتِ إِلَى بِالذِّكْرِ. And he said, and there is no difference between a dead person and a live person and a dead person except with dhikr. فمتى الذي يذكر ربه والذي لا يذكر ربه كمتى الحي والميت. He said, and the similitude of the one that remembers his Lord compared to the one who does not, he said, is like the living and the dead. وفي المسند مرفوعا أكثروا ذكر الله تعالى حتى يقال مجنون. And in المسند الإمام أحمد مرفوعاً means that this hadith is raised to the Prophet ﷺ. The Prophet ﷺ said, remember Allah abundantly, so much so that the people would say he is crazy, majnoon. And now he's going to go into the benefits. He said, وَفِي الدِّكْرِ أَكْتَرْ مِنْ مِئَةْ فَائِدَةٍ. He said, and in dhikr there are more than 100 benefits. إِحْدَاهُمَا أَنَّهُ يَطْرُدُ الشَّيْطَانِ وَيَقْمَعُهُ وَيُكْسِرُهُ. He said, number one benefit is that the dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal chases away the shaitan and subdues shaitan and breaks his back. الثانيه انه يرضي الرحمن عز وجل. Number two, benefit number two, that the dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal pleases Allah the gracious the merciful. الثالثه انه يزيل الهم والغم عن القلب. That benefit number three, that the dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal removes الهم, anxiety and stress and grief and all the like from the heart. الرابعة أنه يجلب للقلب الفرح والسرور والبسط. He said, benefit number four, that the dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal brings about and results in the happiness of the heart, that the heart becomes in a state of rejoice and happiness. الخامسة أنه يقوي القلب والبدن. Number five, that the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal strengthen the heart and the body. السادسة أنه ينور الوجه والقلب. Benefit number six, that the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal puts nur in the light of the servant and his heart. السابعة أنه يجلب الرزق. Number seven, that the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal brings providence. So if you want Allah Azza wa Jal to provide for you, find a job and the like of that, then remember Allah Azza wa Jal. And then he said, التامنة أنه يكسو الداكر المهابة والحلاوة والنظرة. He said benefit number 8, that the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal covers the one that remembers Allah, المهابة, veneration, and الحلاوة, sweetness, والنظرة, and radiance. التاسعة أنه يورثه المحبة التي يروح الإسلام وقطب راحة الدين ومدار السعادة والنجاة. وقد جعل الله لكل شيء سببا وجعل سبب المحبة دوام الذكر. فمن أراد أن ينال محبة الله عز وجل فلينهج بذكره، فإنه الدرس والمذاكرة كما أنه باب العلم. فالذكر باب المحبة وشارعها الأعظم وصراطها الأقوم. And he said, رحمه الله تعالى, in benefit number 9, he said that the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal brings about results in Allah loving that servant. That Allah Azza wa Jal loves the servant, because the love of Allah Azza wa Jal is like the axle of Islam, and the axle of the deen, and the axle of happiness and salvation. And Allah Azza wa Jal, he has made for everything a motive or a reason for it. And he said, and the motive and the cause and the mean to achieve the love of Allah Azza wa Jal is to be in constant remembrance of him subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, whoever wants to achieve the love of Allah Azza wa Jal, then let him be in constant remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. And then he said, فَالذِّكْرُ بَابُ الْمَحَبَّةِ. He said, the remembrance of Allah is the gate to the love of Allah Azza wa Jal. So if you want Allah to love you, then you must remember him much. العاشرة أنه يورثه المراقبة حتى يدخله في باب الإحسان فيعبد الله كأنه يراه ولا سبيل للغافل عن الذكر إلا مقام إلى مقام الإحسان كما لا سبيل للقاعد إلى الوصول إلى البيت. He said number 10, that the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal brings about المراقبة. المراقبة meaning that you fear Allah Azza wa Jal and you watch every step. You're watching Allah Azza wa Jal, that you don't do anything that angers him. You don't do anything that goes against his commandments. That's what muraqaba is. So you're always watching where you're going and what you're doing and what you're saying. He said, and this will put the servant of Allah, will admit the servant of Allah into the gate of al-ihsan. And al-ihsan, which is you worship Allah Azza wa Jal as if you see him, for surely if you don't see him, then he surely sees you. And then he said, and the one who is heedless from the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, there is no way that he would achieve the station of al-ihsan. He said, likewise, that there is no way for someone who is sitting around to get to his house. He said, there is no way that he would be able to get to his house while he's sitting down. The same thing for the person who is heedless, whose heart is heedless from the remembrance of his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he would reach the station of al-ihsan. Al-hadiya ashrah, annahu yuritu al-inabah wa yarruju'u ila Allah azza wa jal. Famata akthara ar-ruju'a ilayhi bidhikrihi awratahu dhalika ruju'ahu biqalbihi ilayhi fi kulli ahwalihi. فيبقى الله عز وجل مفزعه وملجأه وملاذه ومعاده وقبلة قلبه ومهربه عند النوازل والبلايا. And he said, رحمه الله تعالى, benefit number 11, that the remembrance of Allah عز وجل brings about and results in الإنابة, that you return to Allah عز وجل all the time. You return to Allah, he said, when a servant of Allah is in constantly returning to Allah in his all affairs, in his dhikr, that dhikr will result in that the heart of that servant returning to Allah Azza wa Jal in all his affair and in all his condition. So Allah Azza wa Jal becomes his only refuge. He goes to him subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. And he becomes his source subhanahu wa ta'ala. الثانية عشرة أنه يريد القرب منه فعلى قدر ذكر الله عز وجل يكون قربه منه وعلى قدر غفلته يكون بعده منه. He said number 12 that the remembrance of Allah عز وجل results in that servant being close to Allah عز وجل. You get closer to Allah when you remember him. He said according to how much you remember him. He said, according to how much you remember him, the closer you're going to get. So the more you remember him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the closer you're going to get. And the more you're heedless and far away from him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the further away from him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the more heedless, the further away you are from Allah Azza wa Jal. الثالثة عشرة أنه يفتح له بابا عظيما من أبواب المعرفة وكلما أكثر من الذكر ازداد من المعرفة. Number 12 that the remembrance of Allah عز وجل opens up for the servant of Allah a door or a gate, a great door of المعرفة, knowledge about Allah عز وجل. He said and the more the servant of Allah makes dhikr and remember Allah عز وجل the more he will be increased in knowledge. الرابعة عشرة أنه يريد الهيبة لربه عز وجل وإجلاله لشدة استيلائه على قلبه وحضوره مع الله تعالى بخلاف الغافل فإن حجاب الهيبة رقيق في قلبه. He said number 14 that the remembrance of Allah عز وجل will result in veneration, هيبة, veneration of his Lord عز وجل, glorify be he. And he said, because of his intense and strong establishment of that in his heart, is that veneration has a lot of it in his heart. And because of it being strong and intense in his heart, so that results in that veneration of his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, if he's always present with his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's always watching Allah Azza wa Jal, even though Allah is above his seventh heaven, but because of his remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, he feels like he's present. His heart is present with Allah Azza wa Jal. He said, unlike the one who is heedless, he does not feel this. Why? Because of that screen. The screen of veneration in his heart is very thin, it's not thick. It's very thin. He said, الخامسة عشرة أنه يريد ذكر الله تعالى له كما قال تعالى فاذكروني أذكركم. He said number 15 that the remembrance of Allah عز وجل will result that Allah will mention you, will remember you سبحانه وتعالى. He said, ولو لم يكن في الذكر إلا هذه وحدها لكفى بها فضلا وشرفا. He said, if there was no other benefit and no other superiority and no other merit or no other honor in the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal except this one, meaning that Allah will remember you as you remember him, he said, it is enough. It is enough of an honor. It is enough of a nobility. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يرويه عن ربه تبارك وتعالى فمن ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي ومن ذكرني في ملأ ذكرته في ملأ خير منهم. And he brought the hadith القدسي that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said when he relates about his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Azza wa Jal said, whoever remembers me in himself, I will remember him in myself, and whoever remembers me in a group of people, then I will remember him in a group better than them, meaning the angels. السادسة عشرة أنه يورث حياة القلب. وسمعت شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية قدس الله روحه يقول الذكر للقلب مثل الماء للسمك فكيف يكون حال السمك إذا فارق الماء. He said number 16 that the remembrance of Allah عز وجل brings life to the hearts, brings life to the hearts. And he said, I heard Shaykh al-Islam, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, he says, Rahimahullah ta'ala, the remembrance of Allah to the heart is like water to the fish. He said, how would the fish be if it's taken out of the water? السابعة عشرة أنه قوت القلب وروح والروح فإذا فقده العبد صار بمنزلة الجسم إذا حيل بينه وبين قوته. He said number 17, that the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal is the nourishment and the food of the heart and the soul. And if the servant of Allah Azza wa Jal, if he is deprived of that, if he loses that nourishment, that food, which is the dhikr, he said his body becomes like a body that is separated from food, a body without food. There's no food there. He said, وحضرت شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية مرة صلى الفجر ثم جلس يذكر الله تعالى إلى قريب من انتصاف النهار ثم التفت إلي وقال هذه غدوتي ولو لم أتغدى الغداء سقطت قوتي أو كلاما قريبا من هذا. And he said, one time I witnessed شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله after صلاة الفجر. الشيخ رحمه الله شيخ الإسلام, he sat down after صلاة الفجر remembering Allah عز وجل until about the middle of the day. Then he turned towards me and he said, this is my food, this is my nourishment. If I don't get my nourishment from this, he said, my power will drop, will get weakened. He said, and or something statement close to this. وقال لي مرة, لا أترك الذكر إلا بنية إجمام نفسي وإراحتها لأستعد بتلك الراحة لذكر آخر أو كلاما هذا معناه. And he told me one time, I would not leave dhikr except with an intention to relax. Like when I get tired, then I have the intention to relax, and that intention is just to get myself prepared for another dhikr. So I would leave it only at times when I need to relax so that I can be prepared for another dhikr or a statement close to this. الثامنة عشرة أنه يريد جلاء القلب من صدئه كما تقدم في الحديث وكل شيء له صدأ وصدأ القلب الغفلة والهوى وجلاؤه الذكر والتوبة والاستغفار وقد تقدم هذا المعنى. He said number 18, that the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal results in polishment and polish of the heart from its rustiness as it preceded in the hadith. He said, and everything has a sada, has a rust to it. He said, and the rust to the heart is the heedlessness, al-ghafla, wal-hawa, desire. And he said, and this polish is the dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal, wal-tawbah, repentance, wal-istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah Azza wa Jal. And this has preceded, this meaning has preceded before. And at-tasi'ata ashrah, number 19. أنه يحط الخطايا ويذهبها فإنه من أعظم الحسنات والحسنات يذهبن السيئات. He said number 19, that the dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal wipes off sins and takes them away. Wipe them away. فإنه, he said, for indeed the dhikr of Allah is one of the greatest حسنات, good deeds. And والحسنات and the good deeds wipe out the bad ones. He said العشرون أنه يزيل الوحشة بين العبد وبين ربه تبارك وتعالى فإن الغافل بينه وبين الله عز وجل وحشة لا تزول إلا بالذكر. He said number 20, that the remembrance of Allah عز وجل removes الوحشة. الوحشة is like alienation that is between the servant of Allah and between the servant of Allah and his Lord تبارك وتعالى. He said, for indeed the one who is heedless, there is an alienation between him and his Lord. It would not be removed except with dhikr. Inshallah ta'ala, we're going to stop right here. And we don't want to make it too long because there's a lot of benefit. So inshallah ta'ala, we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us from those that use this benefit. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those that remember Him much. And those that remember Allah Azza wa Jal all the time. And those that their tongue are moist with the remembrance of Allah. Walhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. وصلى الله على محمد وبارك الله فيكم وجزاكم الله خيرا.